Hey guys, in this video I want to show you my fail-proof method that I used to create good-looking cartoon heads using only Inkscape. To me, it works 100% of the time, it's super easy to use, and I think it could be helpful for someone struggling with heads. So let's check it out. So what I have in here is a group of pre-made head features, or symbols as I like to call them. I prepare the most common cartoon eyes, noses, mouths, ears, eyebrows, head shapes, and a few other things that are more than enough to start making a cartoon head. They are designed so you can just grab them and build your head by assembling it like a Lego. So before starting, make sure to check the description below, where you can download this same file plus the sample faces in SVG files. It's 100% free, so check it out. Anyway, by using these symbols you can assemble a head. But that won't secure you that it will look good. So I've devised a 3-step method that uses this file with symbols and that carries you through a process of simple, easy-to-do operations. And that for as long as you dedicate it enough time, it will yield nice-looking results consistently. So here's the summary. First step, you use these symbols to quickly slap together a head. You come up with a quick idea and just pick the symbols you think they match with your idea roughly, without worrying about how it looks. Second step, you use Inkscape tools to find your design by exploring multiple quick variations. And third, once you found the design you like, you refine it by once again making quick but smaller variations. If you do all these 3 steps correctly, and they are not hard to do at all, they just take time, you'll end up with a nice looking head. Okay, let's start by exploring the first step. Here what you need is a rough idea. Could be something that you have in your head, or maybe an idea taken from a picture. Or you could just grab in some symbols and throw them together and see what happens. In this video, I'm gonna show you one of each. For the first illustration, I had a rough idea in mind of a long-headed nerdy character with glasses. So here I just grabbed the symbols that I thought could represent that in the best way possible. Notice that I'm just basically throwing them together. I'm not sweating too much where I put them. I just want something visual to get to the next step. As you can see, a head is starting to come clear. It's rough and ugly, but that doesn't matter, we'll make it pretty later on. One thing to keep in mind is that I did have to draw the hair, since there is no symbol for hair. That's one of the things you'll have to work on. But in this cartoony style hair, it's not that difficult to draw anyway. It may happen that you don't have anything in your head, not even a rough idea. Maybe you're a bit more of a visual thinker. In that case, you can find some reference online. Maybe searching funny people or funny animals in Google. In this case, I just searched for witch. And I found this image of the Wicked Witch of the West from The Wizard of Oz. So my head is gonna be loosely based on this image. I guess you could also base yourself on people you know or maybe other characters, for as long as you don't copy them exactly. The idea here is to simply throw in a few symbols that loosely represent the character in your reference. You don't want to copy the character exactly, you just want to have some sort of inspiration, something that guides the creation of your new, unique character. The final case may be that you enjoy the discovering process much more than drawing with an idea in mind. In that case, you can just throw in some symbols together with no regard for how they look, and see if you can find the character later on. So in this case, I'm just pick some random symbols, then put them together. I have no idea what type of character this is gonna be. I'm not sure if it's meant to be a man or woman or child. I just threw stuff together, and I'll worry about making it look like a character later. And that was the first step. As you can see, the end result is really ugly, really rough. And you probably won't want to show it to anybody just yet. But we'll make it pretty in a moment. Now that we have something to work on, we can move on with the next step, finding the actual character. And to do that, we're gonna use an old trick of visual design. We're gonna make a ton of variations and pick the ones that we like the most and get rid of the ones that we don't like. So now I'm gonna duplicate this head, and using the object tool mostly, I'm gonna play around moving the position, scale, and rotation of each symbol to see if I can find new heads. With every major change I make to the head, I create a duplicate that I move to the side, and I keep working on that duplicate. This way I have some sort of log of all the previous designs, allowing me to compare and see what I like and what I don't like. Occasionally you'll see that I'm picking the node tool, and I'll make some small adjustments here and there. But since the goal here is to explore new designs, I'm focusing on making large scale changes, not in fixing something so it looks good. So as you can see, the goal here is to find the design you like the most by exploring a ton of ideas within the bounds of the original concept. You won't see me stray into a design of an old lady, because I'm creating variations on a nerdy guy with glasses. Now, like I said before, most of the operations I'm doing here is changing the location and size and rotation of the symbols I picked originally, and maybe a few small large-scale changes with the node tool, and very occasionally swapping some symbols that I think it would work better. That's all you need to do with each variation. You don't need to redraw them from the bottom up. Just move some things around and you'll get something different enough. Also, don't underestimate the fact that we are keeping previous versions. For once, like I said before, they allow you to check what works and what doesn't work. This allows you to be generally always moving forwards, no matter how small the changes are between variations. Since you can improve at least a bit on something you don't like about a previous version. And that's the key, this incremental process where you do not explore new designs randomly. You iterate over them, one small change at a time. And this guarantees that the more variations you make, the more refined your design is gonna be. So if you do enough variations, you're bound to find a version that you like. In this video, I stopped after a few variations to save on time, but if you want, you can make 20, 30, or 50 variations. You basically stop when you're satisfied with the result. So here I got the three final versions. For the nerdy guy, this is more or less exactly what I had in mind. For the witch, I'm satisfied with the way it looks compared with the picture. And for the third character, I end up discovering a little girl, but if I had continued exploring it, it could have been any other type of character. In this final stage is where we take the character design that's more or less the final, and we actually make it pretty, adding the final color, the final shapes, and all that. Here I recommend you to put the final design to the side and start from zero. Redraw everything that looks rough. You can use the symbols that are in the design if you don't feel like redrawing them, but you'll most likely want to make at least a few modifications so they fit with the character a bit more. But here's the interesting part. You can still use the variation technique. In fact, I strongly recommend you to do that. And this will help you to get smaller variations. Just ask yourself, what would happen if you make the nose just slightly bigger? Or if you skew the whole head just a bit to the side. Why not create multiple variations on the colors of the head or the eyes? This incremental variation technique is super powerful because even in this stage you can still use it to make some last minute refining. This is not like in the previous stage that we use the variations to generate new designs. Here what we want to do is to refine the existing design through variations. And this means generally smaller changes. It's not that the time for big changes is completely gone and you are forbidden to make any big scale change, but since you're happy with the design you chose, and since you've already explored different designs, chances are that now you're more interested in refining a few proportions and shapes and colors, rather than exploring new possibilities. And just like with the previous step, if you make enough variations, you'll end up with a perfectly refined version of your chosen design. And you can even save for later a few of those variations that you thought that were interesting but didn't quite make the cut. Maybe for another character or in case you change your mind. So here are the finalized heads. Here's the first version we started with. Whenever I'm making heads, I always follow this three-step process, and it never fails me. So don't forget to get the download with the SVG file, with the head features and the finalized characters. I remind you that it's completely free. I was thinking in starting to make more tutorials in this style rather than time-lapses, so I would highly appreciate a comment letting me know what you'd prefer. So subscribe to see more Inkscape tutorials, and since you're there, a like would help me a lot. Have a nice day, guys!